Welcome back. In this video, we are going to see what is the swing buttons we use. So swing defines four types of buttons. Please remember, one is J button, J toggle buttons, check boxes, and radio buttons. I hope you are familiar with all these buttons. What is J buttons, check boxes, toggle buttons, and radio buttons. Let us see one by one what it is. So J button class provides functionality of a push button. You know what is a push button, what it does normally, which is having three types of constructors. One is which takes single parameter, which is of type icon, and second one is again which takes single parameter, which is of type string, and third one is string and the icon, which takes two parameters. So I repeat, J button, which provides the functionality of a push button. So let us see. This is a program. I am not going to explain this, so please go through this. And next is about toggle buttons. Toggle buttons, it's a variation of push button, and which has two states. One is pushed and released, so you can which is going to display on the screen, which is whether it is pushed or what released. Next is check boxes. Checkboxes class provide functionality of a checkboxes. You know what is checkbox? So this is the constructor used for this J checkbox, which takes a single parameter. Which provides the functionality of a checkbox. And please remember, J checkbox, which takes a single parameter. Next is about the radio buttons. Radio buttons a group of mutually exclusive buttons. This is an example for your check boxes. So out of these three boxes, you can check anyone. And radio buttons, group of mutually exclusive buttons. And look at the constructor views. J radio button, like your check boxes, even this takes a single parameter. Next is J tab pane, which manages a set of components by linking them with tabs. You can have in a single tab, we can have multiple options. Selecting a tab causes the component associated with the tab to come into the front. You can have multiple tabs, and while selecting a tab, causes the component associated with the tab to come to the front. So let us see an example for this. So before this, let us see what is the general procedure to be used a tab pane to outline. Let us see what has to be outlined for this. So general procedure to use tabs. So there are three procedures. One is to create an instance of J tab pane. First thing is you have to create an instance. Second one is add each tab by calling add tab. You have to add the tab. First you have to create the instance. Then you have to add the tab, and the last one is add the tab pane to the content pane. I repeat. So please go through this. First, you have to create an instance. Second one is you have to add tab by calling add tab, and add the tab pane to the content pane. So these three things are there. So let us see a small example for this. So what it is, we have a few tabs. The first tab is Tetila Cities, so which contains four buttons. Each button displays the name of the city. Second tab is titled the colors, which contains three checkboxes. Each checkbox displays the name of the color. And the third tab is Tetila's flavors. Well, let me show you the program. Yeah, so we have cities, colors, and flavors. We have got three. So again, under the cities, we have four cities. Under colors, we have three colors, and under flavors, we have three flavors. Look at this, how this is done. Cities are done in labels, and colors are done in check boxes, and flavors are done like a scroll this pane. So different things. This is the thing. This is the way which is done. I need not explain the first topic, because this is Now we are going to create an applet for this, and which extends the applet. After this, this is a way which is going to create an interface, a different thread for this, because your main cannot run these methods. So make GUI, let us see what is there in make GUI. So inside the make GUI, as I told, so we have to create an object of the JTabbed pane. This is what we told. We create an instance of a JTabbed pane we have created here. Next is you have to add each tab by calling add tab. So we have to add each tab. How many tabs we have got? We have got city pane, we have got colors, we have got flavors. These all the things will be added to the panes. So this is what the second statement. We add each tab by calling add tab. So we have added three tabs. We have got, we have created a first one, which is create an instance of a JTabbed pane. In the pane, we have added three more tabs. One is for city, the one for the color, and third is for the flavors. Next, let us see. City panel extends the JPanel, and what is in under the cities? What we have? We have got three buttons. One is for New York City. Second is for the London city, and the third is for the Hong Kong city. And look at the next one. And this has to be added to this. Add B3, J button, B4, new button, which is Tokyo. No, actually we have got four. So I told three. It's not the right. Actually, we are adding four cities. Next, we have to again extend J panel. What we do is under the color panel, we are going to add three colors: red, green, and blue. So this is a panel. Before it was button, and this is a panel which is having check boxes. First one was for the buttons. Cities we use buttons, and for the colors we use check boxes. And the third one is combo box. Combo boxes, we are going to add three items. One is vanilla, second one is chocolate, and the third one is strawberry. And add every item to this. Add JCB. JCB is the object of the combo box. So when you do this, we'll be getting the output like this. This is very simple, don't get confused. So initially we have, this is the first one we have done. Under this, we have added three things. We have added three levels. This is the thing. We have added panes. We have added three tabs: cities, colors, and flavors. So this is the tabs. Three tabs we added. Under each, and if you look at the cities, we have got three labels. Under color, we have got three radio buttons. And under flavor, we have got again three more things. So this is all about your JTabbed panes. So it manages a set of components by linking them with tabs. Set of components, not a single component. So please remember that your JTabbed pane is going to manage a set of components by linking them with tabs. So selecting a tab causes component associated with every that tab. Think that you have got three tabs. So if you click the first one, so what are the components associated with that? You'll be getting it. If you click the second one, you'll be getting again what are the components associated with the second one. So this is all about the tabs, their tabs. So please have a look at the program again. So this is a place we are going to create the window for this, and this is the init method should be there, and this is a place we have the run method, run calls make GUI. You know what is the meaning of this you are saying, because your main method cannot run this. You have to create a separate thread for this, runnable thread. So this is a place which is going to do it. And make GUI is going to create three tabs: cities and colors, city, colors, and flowers. And what is there in the city, which is going to do it? City panel has got four cities: New York, London, Hong Kong, and the last one is Tokyo. And what happens with the J panel? So the color panel is having three colors: red, green, and blue. And the flavor panels, because we have got three panels. Flavor panel has got again three different flavors called vanilla, chocolate, and strawberry. So this, for this we are using a combo box. For this we use panels, and the first one we are using again panel. So this is all about this video. Thank you. Have a nice day.